Hello everybody, today we'll be trying out Realms Gate 135 Farm. I will try to unlock the perfect smash if possible. We will see how it goes. I set up a preset here. I am using Halura, Keri, Aspen, Jahra, Mokmen and Holmes. So I cannot get Jahra to CC round 1 because if I use Rui on her, she is just faster than everyone except Mokmen. And that means she will never get to 100 energy round 1. And since the enemies are gonna be faster than her, she will only get to CC at the end of round 2. And you know, by that time, the fight is most likely over. So she will not do anything. That is why I'm using Doom Bell on her. This way she will start with 100 energy after Mokmen active and Halura active. She is also faster than Jahra this way, without Rui. She'll easily have 150 energy, so hopefully that works. She will get some CC in maybe. No idea. I don't even know if that is useful. We will see in the fights, I guess. And I also don't know what else to use in spot 6. Like, I can add a Rogan, I guess, to be faster. I can add a Freya to be a little bit more tankier, I guess. So I'm just gonna try Holmes for now, for some more round 1 CC, I guess. We also have Keri, so with the Aspen Fear and carry energy drain, hopefully they never get to use an active or basic attack. So we are just trying to lock everything down with this team. Meanwhile, Mokman tries to kill everything, and we also have the Jahra Core for helping a little bit with the CC. Also, you know, with the energy feed. So yeah, we are using four Demon Bells, Mokman with Murdering Strings, and Rui Aspen. I think that is. Yeah, let's just try it, we will see. We can obviously change the Holmes easily. I can use an Ignis maybe, I can use a Rogan. Even a Drake could be useful. Because we do face Dark Waves, which has carry. We will see if we lose a fight. I hope not. Are we going the middle route? There is a chest and there is this one. Here we have chest and question mark. I guess we are going the middle. Yeah, let's just see how the fight goes. Preset, realms, and go. Hopefully, I didn't miss anything. Yeah, good start. 1 CC from Jahra, 1 bird from Holmes, and then we drain the energy of Garuda. Looks nice for now. I don't know how we didn't get to use active on Mokman. Like, what happened that round 2? How did Mokman not get an active? We have 4 Demon Bells spent, right? I mean, I guess we could miss it. Which should be very low chance, I believe. However, if we miss it and we also have like a Gaston in the enemy team, we might die. So Shadow might be hard to do. We will see. Yeah, again we are missing the active here. Interesting. Like, out of 4 Demon Bells, only one worked here. Properly at least. So that means we only got 90 energy total from 4 spent Demon Bells. CC seems to be working quite well for now. This is a wave where fear doesn't help much. Because King Barton counterattacks can kill us. And yeah, we can also get stunned like that. I guess that was Cruz. Cruz stun, right? Yeah, this wave seems to be a little bit tough. At least King Barton doesn't do that much damage, so I think we will be fine on that. Unless the Delassium survives, that might be an interesting fight if Delassium gets to use an active. I don't know if he can actually one-shot the Mokman. Because we are using Mokman without Unbending Will, so a burst hero can easily take him down. If he gets lucky, of course. And gets to use an active. Yeah, the problem with Light Wave is crit mark from Asmodel. So if you have a mark on and someone gets to hit with a crit, that is a lot of damage, but yeah, it didn't happen here at least. Not to Mokman at least. Someone died, that is for sure. And we are going the bottom road here. Let's see. 100 more energy, so we will get to the... Do we get to the boss in middle? I think we do, right? Ooh, Dark Heart'ın da o gets to use an active there. Like this team setup could be way better if I could just use Jahra Rui and she would also be maybe faster, I mean slower than someone else. So it is not the best setup. Also we could be using different presets so for different lineups. Because in this wave you kinda need CC removal. For Abyss you need CC removal as well. However in other waves, like the Light Wave, Dark Wave, you can use Mark Purify instead. And for example the Shadow Wave I could use... what is it? Unbending Will. I could use Unbending Will here, because if Gusten targets Mokman, he might just die, right? I mean, he will just one-shot himself, if that happens, so... That is pretty risky. Yeah, see, he targeted Mokman there, and he took a lot of damage. Even from one counterattack. Crit damage, blah blah. Yeah, I guess crit damage is fine. We just want to kill some things, so that we can fear the other heroes. Yeah, the King Barton counterattacks are not enough damage to kill the Mokman, I think. He is pretty tanky. Probably has more than a trillion HP in the fight, I think, right? Is it trillion? Is it billion? Wait, I am confused. I think it is billion, not trillion. His normal HP is like around 700 million, I think. So he should be having with the team buffs, the whatever helps in fights. Also the Realm's Gate buffs, I think. We get extra HP attack or something. So he should be having more than a billion HP, I believe. We can test that very easily, I think. I just need to put Ignis behind him and get Ignis killed round one. And that will tell us the Mokman HP, yeah? Don't wanna do it right now, of course. When I'm trying to get a perfect smash. Don't want to lose any fights, so... If we get a lose, I can try that, I guess. If we don't... Well... I will see what I can do later. Oof, Kerry gets one shot there by the Asmodel mark. And yeah, we can meet the boss in the middle. I believe Plunder is the only puppet I cannot fight at 135. I mean, I can, but it is very close. Like it is, I think some RNG there, whether I lose or not. Based on how many chases Mokman does. If he does a lot of chases, I can win. If he doesn't do much chase, he cannot survive, I believe. Maybe with AMB or something, I could do it. No idea. This is kinda close. I don't like this. Like one, it is taking so many rounds, and two, that Sleepless and carry can do a lot of damage. I do not like that at all. What went wrong there? Did we miss the carry? Should I use a Drake in that way instead of Holmes? Is Holmes even helping right now? I feel like he doesn't do much. Like because I'm not using a Rui on him, he cannot really burp them. So maybe I should just use the Drake instead. Probably. Though can be helpful in some waves, I feel like. At the same time, if it is not consistent, which it is definitely not with a Demon Bell, is it really helping to unlock a perfect smash? I don't think so. We got 10 more fights to go. Yeah, I feel like our CC is fine with just Aspen, right? And I mean, we have the carry, we have Jahra sometimes doing some CC. So maybe we remove Holmes and use a Drake or a Rogan, I don't know. I will change it when we face another Dark Wave. And I'll just keep it, I think. Almost one-shot that wave as a whole. Just a scary left with 1 HP literally. Yeah, that was all round 1 damage. Nice. I don't think we have any way to lose the fortress fight. Because like the only thing that can deal damage here is Penny Reflection, which doesn't affect Mokman that much. He doesn't do the big damage with the initial hit, so it also helps in Aspen Dungeon of course. We face carries, I mean Penny there. Not carries, Penny. And Penny is not the biggest problem because via some other heroes can one-shot themselves with the active. Especially something like SFX. Mokman initial hit is pretty low, and then the chases do a lot of damage. And then the last hit is huge, as you can see. I should also open the number thingy, right? Our damage is so high, it just gets capped by the integer limit, so I should just fix that. I don't like this Demon Bell situation. Why are we never getting actives? Like, what? Yeah, let me just set that up real quick. And also fix our lineup. Yeah, I will just use Drake here. Yeah, the Demon Bell. Yeah, you are good. clean fight. Look at that 3 CC out of 4 heroes from a Demon Bell Jahra. Doesn't even have the third passive, I mean the second passive sublimed. She only has active sublimed, so she doesn't even have that much stuff. I don't think she even has like control stuff in the Awakening. And we have two Light Waves and then Trial of Wraith. I think red is pretty easy, if I remember correctly. So hopefully we don't lose that. Nice, look at that. And here we go. Cope with high burst damage from enemies. Yeah, I think we are. They have extremely high crit and crit damage. That is fine. Should I even use this setup? Like, we cannot CC them. Right? I should probably remove the CC. Use like a Rogan's or Drake or something. Yeah, go in with something like this, I think. That makes more sense to me. I don't know if it is correct. Yeah, I think that was correct. Yeah, I don't think this wave is hard at all. I believe I even beat this at 140 pretty easily. Like, I think it was still 2 or 3 rounds to kill it at 140. And I didn't have even this setup. It was just my normal team, you know. And yeah, that was the first strike. We got halfway there. And we have like three enemies in this one. And then I don't know what is happening here. Wait, I went the wrong way, right? I said we are going middle route because there's a good one here. And this one might be dangerous if it is boss waves. Well, whatever. We have the cavern and then we have the last boss here, which is gonna be a puppet. And I will see that tomorrow, I guess. Thank you for watching. If you liked the video, leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.